had hoped that you might have escaped Hong Kong. Escaped its influences. Its problems.
It seems that the evidence against you has failed to appear. You must be a very dangerous man, Wei Shen.
Released in August of 2012, Sleeping Dogs was originally set to be the next entry in the True Crime series, you know, that game for the PS2, but was cancelled by Activision Blizzard in 2011. About 6 months later, the rights to the game was purchased by Square Enix and renamed just Sleeping Dogs, dropping the True Crime title altogether, though it is still considered a spiritual successor. The game takes place in the bustling city of Hong Kong, where the story follows an undercover officer named Wei Shen, who is tasked with infiltrating and taking down the powerful criminal organization known as the Triads. Sleeping Dogs features brutal combat, great voice acting, a very believable and interesting protagonist, a simple experience system, and a fully realized depiction of Hong Kong. How's it going, fellow geeks? GamerDad79 here, and welcome to Gamer Dad Reviews, where we try to find the best games to fit the lives of us busy adult gamers. One of the things that has really helped me as an adult gamer really start to, like, really enjoy gaming again has been the Steam Deck. It has really allowed me to enjoy the games that I may have missed the first time around, and one of those games is today's review, Sleeping Dogs by developer United Front Games. So, without further ado, let's get into it. Sleeping Dogs follows the story of undercover police officer Wei Shen, who returns to his hometown of Hong Kong after a stint in the US and is tasked with infiltrating and taking down the powerful criminal organization known as the Sun On Yi. Wei's job is to infiltrate the Triad and gather evidence to take him down from the inside. As Wei begins to climb the ranks of the Triad, he must balance his loyalty to his fellow officers and his duty to uphold the law with his growing relationship within the Triad members. Throughout the game, Wei participates in various criminal activities, including drug trafficking, extortion, and straight-up murder, all while trying to maintain his cover. You know, it was really fun to watch this duality of Wei's play out as you take him through the game, navigating the deadly waters of the Triad, and trying to justify breaking his code as a police officer in order for him to remain undercover and do his job. As Wei progresses through the game, he kind of uncovers this conspiracy within the Sun On Yi, and he's got to decide where his loyalties really lay. Will he continue to serve as a cop and bring the members of the Triad to justice, or will he succumb to the temptations of power and money that come with being a high-ranking member of the organization? The story was fantastically told, and it really felt like I was playing something from one of Sony's first-party AAA games, rather than something from a developer who really hadn't done anything like this up to this point. Coupled with the fantastic voice acting, the story really kept me engaged throughout the entire game, and that's something that is super important to me as my gaming time is at a premium. You know, one of the things that games like this kind of have a hard time or struggle to really explain is why the hero or the good guy is doing like all these horrible things but is still considered the good guy. But being a deep undercover cop trying to infiltrate the Triad gives us this really good explanation, almost a perfect explanation, as to why Wei is like killing dudes left and right and selling drugs and all this other stuff. The gameplay is a combination of open world exploration, hand-to-hand combat, shooting, and driving. Think of it as kind of like a version of Grand Theft Auto that's infused with Asian culture. You can explore the city on foot or by a variety of vehicles that includes cars, motorcycles, boats, stuff like that. There are various missions and side missions to take on that help progress the game's story, and it fleshes out the game's world. These missions can involve anything from stealing a car to chasing down suspects as a cop, either on foot or in a vehicle. The hand-to-hand combat system in Sleeping Dogs was really well done. It features a mix of martial arts and brawling, where you're able to perform a wide variety of combos and counterattacks, you know, with ease to take down waves of enemies. As Wei's combat skills improve, he gains access to more powerful moves and abilities. Now, the combat system was deep enough to keep me engaged with new moves unlocking as I gained level, while also being easy and accessible. And that's another thing that's super important to me, and that's the gameplay being easy enough that I'm not feeling like I'm fighting with the game, but also deep enough that it gives me lots of options while playing. One of my favorite parts of the combat was the awesome environmental attacks that you can pull off. Now, some like crazy examples of this were you can slam people's heads into fan blades, you can drop storefront grates on their chest, you can crush them with car engines, and like so many other things. It was so bloody and freaking brutal, but it was really, really fun to pull off. The shooting mechanics are also really well implemented, but they definitely take a backseat to the hand-to-hand combat. You're going to be fighting off mobs of thugs using your martial arts way more than you will, you know, being engaged in a gunfight. Now, while driving is another key element of the gameplay, I felt the cars were really difficult to control, and they felt kind of floaty, and it took me a while to really get used to it. Also, there's karaoke in the game, so there's that. The graphics in Sleeping Dogs were really good, especially for the time of its release back in 2012. It's an open world game with a lot of detail in the city streets, the buildings, and the landmarks. The game's visuals are particularly impressive in capturing, you know, the atmosphere of Hong Kong with its neon lights, the street vendors, and other details that add to the city's immersion. Character models were really well designed, with a lot of detail centered around the facial expressions and the animations during combat and other actions that you do that really helped bring these characters to life. And the cutscenes really gave us this really awesome cinematic experience that's on par with anything AAA studios were doing at the time. Now, what I said earlier about this being like this Asian-infused Grand Theft Auto also is true in the graphics and the world design. The game looked fantastic, especially on the Steam Deck. Sleeping Dogs ran beautifully on the Steam Deck. It's one of those games that really shows off why the deck is so special. I'm now able to conveniently check out these gems that I missed, you know, the first time around all throughout the years. And even on ultra high settings, I was able to get about 30 frames per second. You know, and if I dropped it down to high, I can easily get anywhere between 45 and 60. Playing Sleeping Dogs on the Steam Deck was awesome. It looked great, it played great, and it was super convenient and just a lot of fun. Now, my only complaint about playing on the Steam Deck is that any text that would show up on the screen, whether it's for like subtitles or translating from another language, would be super, super small on the screen with no options at all to kind of increase the UI scale. So that made it kind of a pain in the ass, but it wasn't anything that I couldn't overcome. After finishing Sleeping Dogs on the Steam Deck, I really regretted not checking this out when it was first released. On Metacritic, the game is sitting at a very respectfully 80 for the PC version. Though, I would argue that the score should be higher, at least in my opinion. I had a blast playing Sleeping Dogs. And while it did ultimately sell well, it was unfortunately deemed a failure by Square Enix, as it kind of failed to meet sales expectations. Due to this failure, the planned sequel was canceled, which really sucks, because I would have loved another entry in this series. Sleeping Dogs was an absolute blast to play, and it's still worth checking out today. I highly recommend it. The game goes for about $20 on Steam, with the console versions running around the same price, but it's one of those games that is, you know, consistently on sale. I can't recommend Sleeping Dogs enough, no matter how you play it. But playing it on the Steam Deck was freaking amazeballs. Now, back in March of 2017, a film adaptation of Sleeping Dogs was actually announced, with Donnie Yen set to star as Wei Shen, but there really hasn't been anything in the way of news about it since then. But I think this could be a really awesome game to adapt. But personally, you know, with recent things like, you know, The Last of Us on HBO, I think this would be better as a big budget TV show. There's just a lot of content there. All right, fellow geeks, that is it for today's video. Let me know in the comment section below if you've ever played Sleeping Dogs and what you thought of it. You got a game recommendation for me? Also, let me know in the comment section below. And until next time, I'm GamerDad79. Keep on geeking on.